The PlayStation Store's double discount and games under $15 sale ends tomorrow. I am pretty certain they're going to kick off another sale tomorrow. Might even be the summer sale, not exactly sure. But to wrap things up, I do want to highlight some of the best deals that are available right now across those two sales, mostly highlighting the double discount sale. Remember, with this sale, you really want to be a PlayStation Plus subscriber because you do get double the discount. In reality, it's just that non-PS Plus subscribers get absolutely screwed. That's really what's going on here. But nevertheless, let's get right into it and let's talk these deals. Starting things off, we have Batman Arkham Knight Premium Edition for $9.59. Batman Arkham Knight is a great open world title. Not my favorite of the Arkham franchise, but still an excellent game. I know some people weren't as high on the Batmobile sections, but I thought those sections were honestly not that bad. And the Premium Edition does include some additional content, and it's the ideal version of the game. You get the season pass in there. Visuals are stunning, and overall a pretty good game. Not as strong from a narrative standpoint as the first two titles, but still pretty darn good for $9.59. Okay, moving on from that, let's stick to the superhero theme. Injustice 2 is available for $4.79. If you guys know me, you know that I'm not huge on fighting games these days. I'm not like a gigantic fan of them, but I play them for fun, not for a competitive play or anything like that, and Injustice 2 is one of those games that I had a very good time with. Obviously, some very notable characters featured in the game. Now, this is the base game. You have to bear that in mind. The Legendary Edition does go on sale from time to time and includes a ton of additional content, but the base game for $4.79 I thought was pretty good, and if you're looking for a fighting game with some notable characters, I don't think it's a bad pickup at all. Next up, we have Valkyria Chronicles 4, the Complete Edition. 60% off for $19.99. I love this game. Valkyria Chronicles 1 was excellent. Valkyria Chronicles 4 is a bit better in the sense they added a class and there is an easy mode as well. Valkyria Chronicles 1, I recommended to some of my boys and they found the game to be kind of challenging. So maybe with VC4, you want to play on the easy route. I think normal is completely doable, but yeah, that option is there. Quite a bit of side missions in here as well, and the content is there in spades. And this is a long, long game. While it doesn't have that gigantic overworld or a gigantic open world or anything like that, it's still got a ton of content for your money. And for what you're paying, this is a great, great price that I would highly recommend at $19.99. Again, I think it's a great price because you're getting a lot of content, you're getting the additional stuff with the Complete Edition, and it's just a great game anyway, so you might as well pick it up. Fans of tactics RPGs are really going to be into it as well. $19.99, a good pickup for that. Next up, we have the Skyrim Special Edition and Fallout 4 Game of the Year Bundle, $32. So it's Fallout 4 and Skyrim. I think you guys know what to expect out of this one. Fallout 4 was a bit of a disappointment. Was it a bad game outright? No, but very sloppy in certain areas and not that iconic experience that Fallout 3 was, but still a decent game. Skyrim is obviously great. Unfortunately, the Special Edition doesn't take it up to the level that I would like it. I would have liked it to be 60 frames per second and all that good stuff, but Skyrim's still an iconic game, and hell, after the dastardly version that was the PlayStation 3 version, you know, the Special Edition is a nice improvement from that. And the PlayStation 3 version of Skyrim was the first version that I ever played, so not the best way to experience a Skyrim for the first time, but I still managed to beat it on the PS3, and then the PS4 version is great. Next up, we have Watch Dogs 2, which is 80% off for $9.99. I think Watch Dogs 2 is a pretty decent game. I often compare it to Assassin's Creed 2 and what Assassin's Creed 2 did for Assassin's Creed. Watch Dogs 2 did it to an extent with Watch Dogs. Watch Dogs 1, let's just say, had its issues, and Watch Dogs 2 I thought was a much better game. It didn't have the as serious of a tone to it, but I still thought it was a very enjoyable game, and you can play a demo, and it notes it has 3 hours of gameplay, so if you play the demo and you like it, maybe that'll be the gateway into buying the game. But I think $9.99 is a pretty good pickup for this one. Obviously, Watch Dogs is a franchise kind of slipping a little bit, given that Watch Dogs Legion is like $17 already after its release last October, but hey, Watch Dogs 2 I still thought was pretty good, and I think it's a worthwhile pickup for $10. Next up, we have Odin's Sphere of Love Treasure for $24. That's 60% off, and yes, this game has held up in price for quite a while. Would I like to see it cheaper? Yes, given that it's originally a PlayStation 2 game, it hasn't been going cheaper, so hey, I'm gonna give it a recommendation. Odin's Sphere was a game that was great on the PlayStation 2, a little bit unsung, but at the same time was a greatest hits title, I believe, by the end of it. So yeah, a lot of people did check it out. This is an upgraded version of that game. If you're familiar with VanillaWare titles, Dragon's Crown, Muramasa the Demon's Blade, Odin Sphere is going to be right up your alley. Visuals are gorgeous. I love the stylization to this game. And if you're into 2D action RPGs, this is going to be one to enjoy. It has a decent bit of content and, of course, upgraded graphics from the original release. $24 is steep, but I still think it's a game worth checking out for those of you that like your 2D action titles. Next up, we have Red Dead Redemption 2 Ultimate Edition, which is down to $33.99 with PS Plus. So this typically goes for $100, so you definitely want to cop this at a discount, and right now you can get it at a significant discount. This Ultimate Edition includes a ton of additional content, exclusive story mode content, and Red Dead Online content, which Red Dead Online is kind of a meme, so maybe you don't want to jump into that. But Red Dead Redemption 2 itself is an excellent game. It's kind of unfortunate that Red Dead Redemption 2 sometimes is judged as an overall package. I mean, as it should be, but the single player of Red Dead Redemption 2 is so good and at such a high quality level that I feel like just that alone is warranting a purchase. But hey, obviously you do have to assess the online mode as well. I just don't like to think about it, but Red Dead Redemption 2 is excellent. The attention to detail is top-notch. Voice acting is great. Story is amazing, and it's got so much content in a game that's going to keep you busy for a very, very long time. $34, I think, is a good pickup. And yeah, it did come out all the way back in 2018, but guess what? It was at such a high level that I feel like it's still worth a pickup to this day at this high of a price point. And I mean, 66% off the $100 price point is pretty good. So yeah, you can even jump into the Red Dead Online if you're feeling a little feisty. But if nothing else, that single player component is absolutely worth it, and I highly, highly recommend it. Next up, we have Shadows of the Tomb Raider, $13.99. This is 65% off. This is the definitive edition with all of the additional content. My issues with SOTR prior to the game even releasing was Square Enix's crazy DLC release plan, and that's really what held the game back for me. The game itself is quite good, even though the story leaves a lot to be desired. I think from a gameplay standpoint, content standpoint, if you assess it from that and what you get out of the Definitive Edition, it is really good, and I've really enjoyed the Tomb Raider trilogy since 2013. I feel like it's really revitalized the franchise, and even if SOTR wasn't as well received as ROTR, it's a game that's definitely worthwhile to check out, and I think for $14, you should go give it a look. It's great price. You're gonna have a pretty good time with it, and it's got a decent bit of additional content while not overstaying its welcome. It's not like it's got an obscene amount of content. Next up, if you're one of the four people in the world that don't own God of War 2018, I would highly recommend you to get it for $9.99. It is an excellent game, and God of War is at the top tier of the PlayStation exclusives alongside the Spider-Mans of the world or whatever games you assess at the top of the PlayStation exclusive hierarchy. This is a great story, even if you never played the original God of War games, God of War 1 to 3 and Ascension, Chains of Olympus, and all that good stuff. This is really the evolution of God of War that I wanted to see, and I loved 2018 more than I liked any other God of War game in the past. Had a different tone to it. Kratos is a little bit more mature. Of course, you have Atreus in there as well. And I'm very excited to see where the franchise goes moving forward with God of War Ragnarok and everything like that. But if you never played God of War 2018, obviously it's a good pickup. It is available in the PlayStation Instant Game Collection on PS5, so that is something to consider as well. But lastly, we have Kingdoms of Amalur: Rite Reckoning, 50% off $19.99. Kingdoms of Amalur, I think, is a fantastic open-world RPG. Story is nothing to write home about, but I really enjoy the action-oriented combat system, where some open-world titles are just a little bit more slower in their combat. Kingdoms of Amalur kept a fast-paced, action-oriented system that's more reminiscent to traditional action games, and for $19.99, I think Kingdoms of Amalur: Rite Reckoning is a pretty good pickup. Unfortunately, not the Fate Edition, but hey, what can you do? Still a good buy here. And that's gonna wrap up this one. Again, games under $15 as well as double discounts ending tomorrow. And I think you actually have the entirety of tomorrow to pick up any of these games, so it should be ending on the 24th at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, 10 a.m. Pacific. Don't quote me on that, but just pick up the games as soon as possible if you're interested in any of them. That's going to wrap up this one. Do sound off with all of your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.